The Intel Z790 chipset is our top-of-the-line platform for gamers, creators, and enthusiasts. It powers a pretty big collection of motherboards, from streamlined setups that maximize value to buffed-up beasts that turn everything up to 11. And that one looks like a stormtrooper.
Let me see your identification.
I'm Aaron Escobedo, a technical marketing engineer here at Intel, and we've gathered a stack of different Z790 boards to help you find the right one for your next Raptor Lake or Alder Lake build. Introducing the Z790. The motherboard acts like a backbone of your PC, you know, connecting components like graphics, storage, memory, and the processor. It's powered by the chipset, or the PCH, which is where the Z790 comes in. Motherboards based on this chipset have an LGA 1700 socket that works with both 13 and 12th gen Intel Core processors. The Raptor Lake flexes more cores, with up to 8 performance cores and 16 efficient cores. And it reaches frequencies up to 6 GHz out the box with a Core i9-13900KS. The Z790 unlocks overclocking for K-series CPUs so you can push even higher speeds on your own. And in addition, the motherboard also helps overclocking by beefing up the power circuitry, often referred to as phases, used to feed the CPU. While our latest CPUs do support both DDR4 and DDR5 memory, the motherboards have to pick one or the other. So we want to make sure that your board and RAM are on the same page. Raptor Lake does push DDR5 up to 5600 megatransfers per second, and you can easily go faster with XMP modules validated for higher speeds. And we introduced desktop PCs DDR5 along with PCIe Express 5.0. The processor itself has 16 lanes of Gen 5 for a graphics card, and Z790 boards can split them into a pair of 8-lane links to combine the graphics and storage, or multiple GPUs. You'll also get 4 Gen 4 lanes from the CPU, plus up to 20 more from the chipset, so there's loads of capacity for fast SSDs. The chipset's PCIe lanes are an array of 38 flexible high-speed I/O lanes that the motherboard makers can also use for SATA and USB. The Z790 boards will support up to 8 SATA drives and tons of USB, including the latest standards like 2x2, 2x1, and 1x1 flavors. Some boards also add a separate Thunderbolt 4 chip that maxes out at 40 gigabits per second for cutting-edge peripherals. Motherboards will have some form of networking with this lot, starting at 2.5 gig Ethernet that'll leave single gigabit in the dust. Many also add Wi-Fi 6E that unlocks access to an exclusive 6 gigahertz band with less traffic. Each board does have its own personality and offering, so let's take a closer look. The ASRock Z790 PRO RS is one of the most affordable boards we're looking at today. There's actually 3 different versions. This one supports DDR5. The PRO RS Wi-Fi adds integrated Wi-Fi 6E and Bluetooth. And there's a PRO RS/D4 that's made for DDR4 memory. The PRO RS targets what you might call base level for high-end PCs. It has all the slots and ports needed for an enthusiast-grade machine, including for up to 4 NVMe drives. All the Gen 5 lanes on the CPU are routed to a reinforced x16 slot for graphics, so the SSD slots max out at Gen 4 speeds. You get a complete collection of ports at the back and an integrated I/O shield that you can't forget to install, but despite the affordable price tag, there's still ample power for our fastest desktop CPUs, plus a splash of RGB lighting. The next level up would be the ASRock Z790 Steel Legend Wi-Fi, and this one sweetens the pot with upgraded specs and looks.
Blue steel?
There's a bigger heatsink for more chipset and more for the M.2 slots, complete with accent lighting compatible with ASRock's polychrome sync software. The top slots here shares Gen 5 PCIe lanes with primary graphics cards, so you can tap into the new breed of high-performance SSDs hitting the market. Fully loaded, this board can take up to 5 NVMe drives along with up to 192 gigabytes of DDR5 memory. It's got a couple more CPU power phases than the PRO RS and uses higher grade capacitors from Nichicon. There's a lot more USB around the back here too, especially with faster 3.2 ports, along with integrated Wi-Fi 6E and Bluetooth. As an added bonus, you get a special bracket to help you support the weight of these heavy graphics cards. The ASRock Z790 Taichi steps up to even more premium territory. Its sleek black theme shouts high-end, while the 8-layer circuit board adds real enthusiast street cred. The extra PCB layers help to reduce signal noise, especially with more features on board. The Taichi has the same reinforced slots as the Steel Legend, plus even more power phases overall. It can split those Gen 5 PCIe Express lanes between two graphics cards or one GPU and one SSD, and you get lots of bells and whistles like the Intel Killer, our wired and wireless networking suite that team up to maximize throughput. An upgraded ESS Saber DAC designed for high quality headphone audio, Lightning gaming ports optimized for high-speed mice and keyboards, and dual Thunderbolt 4 ports that are perfect for creators. This diverse collection of features makes the Taichi flexible enough for a wide range of builds. With the tough gaming Z790 plus Wi-Fi, ASUS brings together essential elements of a gaming motherboard for more mainstream builders. The military-inspired design has a unique look that matches other components within the tough gaming alliance. ASUS emphasizes the board's stability and cooling, which includes heat sinks for 3 of the 4 SSD slots. Like other more entry-level models, all Gen 5 lanes go to the primary x16 slot. ASUS also integrates a handy Q-release lever that helps eject longer graphics cards that would otherwise block the slot's retention tab. I needed this. That's part of the collection of DIY-friendly features that also includes tool-free latches for securing SSDs. This isn't some should've could've board. Smart specs and features like the Wi-Fi 6E lay the foundation for a solid build. If you prefer DDR4, you can also check out the Tough Gaming Z790 Wi-Fi D4. ASUS's more upscale Republic Gamers family will include the Strix Z790E Gaming. It's teeming with tuning options, including a one-click cooling optimizer and an automatic overclocking feature that profiles your CPU and cooling. These software utilities complement a full suite of controls in the BIOS if you want to tweak outside the OS. There are lots of little touches for enthusiasts, like a push button that'll eject the graphics cards and a CMOS reset switch accessible from the back panel. Like the rest of the rear I/O, the spec sheet is stacked. And you can load up to 5 M.2 drives with Gen 5 slots supporting the larger heatsink to keep those faster SSDs cool. Add Wi-Fi 6E and upgraded Supreme FX audio, and you got a board that pushes the limits on multiple fronts. The ASUS ROG Maximus Z790 Extreme is designed for those who refuse to compromise. This board takes full advantage of the chipset, including the ability to split the Gen 5 PCIe Express lanes between a pair of graphics cards. And you'll get the most of the CPU with 24 plus 1 team power stages rated for 105 amps each. In addition to Wi-Fi, you get dual Ethernet controllers, one of which supports blazing 10 gigabit speeds. Thunderbolt 4? Yep. A premium ESS DAC augments to the audio? That too. The aesthetic is super clean, with a shroud to help hide cabling and fan headers clustered in key spots around the edges. The designers here went well beyond RGB lighting with programmable grid of over 200 mini LEDs plus a separate live dash OLED. If you have deep pockets, the Maximus Z790 Extreme lives up to its name across the board. EVGA rose to popularity with our graphics cards, so it's no surprise that the Z790 Classified can take two of them, sharing Gen 5 lanes from the CPU. The high-end design is built on a 12-layer board and rotates the socket and DIMM slots by 90 degrees to facilitate smoother airflow and cable management. The VRM shroud hides twin fans that help cool the 19-phase power delivery as well. The edge-facing connectors and PCB cutout make it easier to tuck cables out of the way. Serious overclockers can also use probe headers to monitor voltages in real time with a multimeter. And there's 3 BIOS chips for additional layers of failsafe. You can flash the BIOS without a CPU too. EVGA needs larger extended ATX form factor to fit everything, including the 10 gigabit Ethernet and integrated Wi-Fi. This is truly a board for those who want more. Gigabyte's Z790 AORUS Elite AX is designed to maximize gaming bang for your buck. It checks all the right boxes for a modern build without blowing your budget. The power delivery here has 16 twin phases for the CPU core, each rated at 90 amps. All the Gen 5 lanes in the CPU run directly to the primary graphics card slot. And you can add up to 4 SSDs via the M.2 slots. The integrated I/O shield surrounds a good selection of ports, including the antenna for all the integrated Wi-Fi 6E, and a bunch of USB 2.0 for peripherals that don't require speed. There's even a handful of little features for the DIY crowd, like easy latches that make it easier to drive graphics cards and secure SSDs without reaching for a screwdriver. The Z790 AORUS Elite AX lays a solid foundation with room to grow. Now, the Z790 platform has as much appeal for creators as it does for gamers and enthusiasts. And the Gigabyte Z790 AERO G takes this to heart. The visual design trades the militant black heatsinks for sleek, silver and white accents that create an entirely different vibe. Gigabyte includes a special Vision Link port that can pass data, video signals, and up to 60 watts of power over a single Type-C connection that's ideal for drawing tablets. Thunderbolt would have pushed the price beyond affordable territory, but you can still add in support via optional add-in cards. Because bandwidth can be critical for creators, the board punches above its weight with the ability to split the Gen 5 PCIe Express lanes between a pair of graphics cards or a GPU and SSD tag team. Integrated Wi-Fi and smart overall spec make the Z790 AERO G a well-balanced option with a different approach to performance and style. They say you shouldn't bring a knife to a gunfight, but what about a Tomahawk? The MSI MEG Z790 Tomahawk Wi-Fi wants to be the weapon of choice for gamers looking to mix value and performance. The spec sheet here hits all the right notes. With Gen 5 lanes for graphics, 4 M.2 slots equipped with heatsinks, and support for up to 192 gigabytes of RAM with 48 gigabyte models. Wi-Fi 6E joins a full range of I/O, including dual Type-C ports at the back, plus buttons to clear the CMOS from the outside of the case and flash the BIOS with only a power supply connected. 18 total power phases are primed for high-end CPUs and overclocking, and support for Mystic Lighting lets you add RGB via standard strips and compatible wall panels. You should have some cash to spare though, because the Tomahawk covers key bases without emptying your wallet. MSI delivers high-end features and a distinctive look with the black and gold MEG Z790 Ace. This thing's a beast, and not just because there's a dragon lurking on the left here of the socket. The larger extended ATX footprint makes room for an array of premium features like dual Thunderbolt 4 ports, dual 2.5 gig Ethernet, and integrated Wi-Fi 6E. Enthusiast extras are everywhere, from the smart button in the rear I/O panel that you can program with different functions, to the aluminum black plate, designed to improve stiffness and heat dissipation. You can route half of the CPU's Gen 5 PCIe Express lanes for graphics cards or an SSD, load up on additional drives and another expansion card, and go to town with overclocking with 24 phases just for the CPU cores. The Ace plays with a full deck. The most expensive board of the bunch inspires an appropriate amount of awe. Featuring a refined design with understated lighting, the MSI MEG Z790 Godlike stands out even before you look at the specs. And when you do, you'll see that this board has everything. More power phases for the CPU, adding up to 26 plus 2. Full flexibility for Gen 5 graphics and storage. Support for a whopping 7 NVMe drives, so many that one runs at Gen 3 speeds. Dual Thunderbolt 4 ports for high-end peripherals, and all of the networking, including a 10 gigabit LAN. There's even a 4.5-inch touchscreen that's part of a separate M-Vision dashboard, and you can display system information, tuning options, and a variety of other additional tools like weather, media controls, and customizable shortcuts. If the Ace is really playing with a full deck, then the Godlike is sitting at the high rollers table. It's not just me, right? This NZXT N7 Z790 looks straight out of the Galactic Empire. The full metal cover comes in white or black, so you can choose between the light side or the dark side. This board is all about aesthetics, with 6 RGB lighting headers and 7 fan channels, all customizable via NZXT's CAM utility. And the straightforward spec has enough oomph for a powerful system that lives up to its look. Angular heatsinks help keep the ample VRMs cool with all the processor's Gen 5 PCIe Express lanes going straight to your graphics card. With 3 M.2s, there's enough capacity for most builds, and if you want more NVMe storage, you can use the extra x16 slot. All the bases are covered here, like Wi-Fi 6E, the latest USBs, but I think you'll agree, this is no basic board. The Intel Z790 chipset is the common thread between the 13 motherboards we looked at here today. That, and the support for 13 Gen core processors. Wait a minute, did we do that on purpose?
Yeah, maybe.
Anyway, all these boards benefit from cutting-edge performance, connectivity, and expansion offered by each of the platform, but puts a different spin on the formula. That translates to lots of variety, so you can find the right board for your next desktop PC.